guys, and welcome back to the Bristol Prepper channel. So today guys, we are doing a budget bushcraft prepping buys part 5, I believe now. I did do one the other day, or not so long ago, a few days ago, whatever. But I picked up some more stuff and I really wanted to show you guys some of the stuff you might have seen before. 2 seconds ago, took the camera down. You might have seen it before in my shopping video. Well, I went online shopping. I did pick some bits and pieces up, but in case you didn't catch it, I'm going to show you guys anyway. So the first thing I picked up was from Wilco, a medium coarse sand block. These are rubberized block, not rubber, but like squidgy type block, see that? The abrasive sides. This is the medium and this is the coarse. So it's double sided, which is pretty cool. I find these are amazing, right? These are 90p, so not even a pound. And these are amazing for getting rid of rust and stuff like that on your knives. Just a small amount of grit, just to kind of, when you're cleaning your knife up, it's got some rust on it, or axes, and you're trying to clean the surface rust off, this is the best thing for it. Because it's a good size, get it in your hand and really get those edges, which is pretty good. And I prefer this using some of the sandpapers, because it's just a little block, so cheap, I can just buy them, and they fit in the kits for all knives. So that's the first thing I bought, that one. Then the second thing I bought was this hobby box, or like a small toolbox, as you can see, for a pound. Pretty cool little toolbox. It's quite small, but I'm going to use it for putting in my blade maintenance stuff, so sharpening stones, stuff like that. The box is cheaply made, like it's obviously cheap plastic and all that. I don't need it to be heavy duty or hard wearing. It's just got to kind of sit there. It's got a cool little handle so I can carry it. A nice little clip on the front there, which is pretty cool. Works, do you know what I mean? It's functional. And for a pound, £1, you can't move. Like, that's spot on for a pound. So, yeah, that's that. So it's got a little padlock lock on the front as well. I did want to lock it, but yeah, cool little hobby box for me. I also picked up, you're going to laugh guys, but a massive bag of marshmallows. So we were out and saw these in the store. These were £2. That's really cheap for marshmallows this size and for the weight of them. There's so many in here. As you can see, it's loads. So we picked these up because my stepdaughter, she's coming out a lot more of me now, loads more filming. When we go out and doing bushcraft and stuff like that as well. She comes out quite a lot camping. She's getting really into it. And I just want to treat her, and sort of a treat we can take, chuck a few in like a zip bag, zip type sandwich bag, and then we can have some marshmallows over the fire. She'll love that, which is pretty cool. And the last stages, the last little while, so we're not going to take them all at once. We'll just take a couple with us or whatever, and chuck them in a sandwich bag or whatever. My sort of treat for her. But yeah, that's pretty cool. £2 for all of those, which is pretty sweet. They're funny. Then I also bought, guys, one of these. One of my friends is a bushcrafter on YouTube. I'm not going to say his name, so I don't know whether you want me to say it or not. But he's got these grill type things. I've got this one. And then the last thing I bought was this one. So I've got two. This one is a really small one, so I can chuck this even in my EDC bag if I was just going for a light day filming trip. But I want to cook some sausages. This is a sausage rail, so you can put all your sausages on there. Obviously clamp it together with this clamp, and then I obviously have that over the fire. I bought this because I just thought it's handy. Just if I'm going on and think I'm like, fuck it, I'm gonna go like glamping or like posh bushcrafting or whatever you'll call it, and I'm gonna go heavy, I'm gonna take a little bit of heavier stuff. I might take my day hammock just to chill out in it. So I'm going a little bit heavy and I'm not too worried about the weight, I'm not going all that far, I'm just chilling out. So that's why I bought this. I thought it'd be good for that sort of thing. And this was only 50p. 50p for that. Cool. End of season sales, guys. Is all what it's all about. End of season sales. Because obviously it's coming to a close now of the summer. Not the summer. The camping and festival season's coming to a close now. All the biggest ones have come and gone. So it's obviously coming to a close. So this is when you get all the best bargains. So it's when you got to go out and have a look, guys. And you get all your bushcraft and stuff. Some extra stuff you can take with you. Get it real cheap. So like I said, that one was 50p, and then this one, my friend has got this exact one, the friend I was talking about, I think he calls his Sir Grillalot. Sir Grillalot, which is pretty funny. So, yeah, so this was a nice one. It's a big one. So if I'm going for a big, maybe a weekend camp or maybe a certain amount of time, a longer certain period, I'd take this one. And obviously you can cook everything on this. Same sort of thing as the other one, but not with the slots. It's just like the normal grill, which is pretty cool, but it's still not that big. I could fit that in the back of my, I could fit that in my 5.11 72 hour rush pack, down the actual camelback area. So I didn't use a camelback. I could fit that in the camelback area, so I wouldn't even, and it's not heavy at all, I wouldn't realise the weight, and it's be pretty cool to have it. So it's not a necessity, and it's not something I take every time, but for 50p for this one, and then only a pound for this one, it was a pretty good bargain. Even if I only use them on the barbecue, like for when we have family barbecues or whatever, they're handy to have then. Just a really cool item to have. So yeah, so like I said, for £1 and then 50 pence, you can't really moan, can you? It's a pretty sweet deal on that one. And I got those from B&M. We did go in B&M in one of my videos, but and we did see these, but at the time it wasn't the offer. The offer wasn't on, and like the sale wasn't on, so then I went to a different B&M in a different part of Bristol, and then found those when I was filming the Wilco shopping video. I found those in B&M, which is pretty cool. Oh, and the marshmallows come from B&M as well. My missus found those, and my daughter, what I done, like I said, pretty cool. So we found some quite cool stuff there this time. I was really happy with some of the purchases, especially the box. My box is the favourite one. The box is, I just love it, how it's so small, compact. It's not too bad, like, it's not flimsy plastic. I'm sure it's not like, it's not digging in or not bending enough. It's quite hard, but for a pound, like, I can't moan. If it lasted me 6 months, I'd be happy, even a month, because it's £1. I mean, I could have bought two and just kept the other one, just in case. But the other one they had there was in, let's say, poor condition. It was definitely knackered. All the head was coming off and the clips were broke. It looks like somebody got hold of it and wrecked it. But yeah, if I do see another one, I will definitely pick one of these up, because I do normally buy the see-through containers. If you've seen before, the small little ones, just for small organising stuff. And they were 80 pence. And this is a pound, and it's like bigger and bulkier, and it's got a handle, and I just prefer this. But yeah, I really like that one. God, it goes on, don't I, guys? Goes on, I get carried away. Yeah, guys, so hopefully you've enjoyed that and saw or liked all the stuff I got. If you find any good bargains or know anywhere cool that you'd suggest I should go and have a look at, smash it down beneath in the crotch box. Or if you find something really cool you want to show me, smash it down beneath. Show me a VR. I'd love to see a VR. Somebody do a VR. I've never seen one. So somebody do a VR telling me, show me your bushcraft and prepping buys. Some stuff you've bought lately, I'd love to see it, guys. I'd love to see it. It'd be incredible. Especially for somebody from overseas, so America, Holland, anywhere you are, that's not England. I'd especially like to see that, because obviously not being in England is different for me to see what you guys can get and all that, which would be pretty cool. So yeah, guys, that'd be mint if you could, somebody could do me a VR. Somebody could do that for me, it'd be amazing. If you like this or got anything to say, smash it down beneath in the crotch box. Otherwise, like this video if you enjoyed it. Also, subscribe to my channel. It helps my channel massively. I appreciate everybody who subscribes. So smash that button, pretty please. And yeah, guys, at the moment, we've got the t-shirts here and we've got the jumpers. So if you want a t-shirt or a jumper, message me. I'll tell you prices and all the rest of it. Or go back and check the videos out, because there is a video for each jumper and the t-shirts telling you all about the prices and sizes and all the rest of that good stuff. So go back and check that there, mate. What else is going on? That's it really, guys. If you could like me on Facebook as well, that helps me out, because Facebook is the place where it's at. If you want to find out what's going to be on my channel coming up soon, or that's where all the stuff happens, what's coming up, and like they get all the, because it's so easy, because it's on my phone. I upload pictures and say what's going to happen soon or what's happening that day. That's the place to be at. So if you're on Facebook, like me on Facebook, and you won't regret it, guys. It's also a great way to talk to me. So if like people talking to me, asking me questions and chatting to me, it's just easier on Facebook, you know what I mean, because it's quicker and shit like that. Anyway, guys, I'm going on as always. Whew. Anyway, guys, Stay prepared as always. I'll catch you guys another day, another way.